अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। इंफॉर्मेशन बॉक्स टिकट लाइफस्टाइल पब्लिक हेल्थ। दिस इज़ द कंटिन्यूइंग ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन टू हेल्थ मेकिंग हेल्थी चॉइसेस। डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल। सम ऑफ द फैक्टर्स दैट डिटरमाइन हेल्थ मे सीम टू बी बियॉन्ड योर इन्फ्लुएंस। इट इज़ ट्रू दैट एवरीवन हैज पर्सनल लिमिट्स। योर हेरिडिटी एंड समटाइम्स योर फिजिकल इन्वायरमेंट आर नॉट things you can change or control. However, you can still take responsibility for changing your behavior. This responsibility involves weighing the risk connected to the decisions you make. Actually, what is a risk? The possibility that something bad will happen is a risk. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon button. Risk also can be defined as a degree of danger that goes along with an opportunity. All risks have possible negative outcomes. However, some risks are worth taking. For example, suppose that you have the chance to join a school team. You risk a possible injury while playing to achieve the sense of accomplishment that comes with being on a team. You may decide that the pleasure of playing is worth the risk of injury. By being in good health, you can also reduce the risk of physical injury. How can you determine the risk involved in an action? Many risks that relate to health choices have been studied. Scientists use statistics to measure the risk. Statistics is a branch of mathematics that helps determine the possibility or odds that sometimes will occur. The information about the possibility is called statistic risk and can help you make healthy choices. For example, statistics indicate that in this country, the chances of dying from cancer is about 20%. In other words, 2 out of every 10 deaths are due to some kind of cancer. Therefore, the risk of death from cancer is quite high. However, statistics also shows that 80% of all cancer are related to the things over which you have some control. In other words, you can make choices that will reduce your risk of developing cancer. Include such things as avoiding pollution, not smoking, and eating a diet high in fiber. If you do these things, you are less likely to develop cancer. How to fight the odds? A statistic risk is based on what has happened to a group of people in a recent year. But the risk can change. If enough people change their health behavior, the statistic will also change. Fighting the odds begins with each individual. For example, you may know that there is a history of diabetes in your family. Diabetes is a serious condition that may be brought on by being overweight. You may love sweets, but because you are aware of your danger of developing diabetes, you limit the amount of sugar you eat and keep your weight down. You have evaluated the risk involved and have acted on it. To evaluate means to weigh or judge information. In understanding what can happen if you give in to your sweet tooth, you have evaluated the information you have. Deciding to give up sweets and maintain your weight, you have acted on your evaluation so that you have reduced your personal health risk. Just as you act to reduce the health risk to yourself, you can also act to reduce health risk to others. For example, crossing the street involves some personal danger. You can reduce your risk by looking both ways, obeying traffic signals, and staying in the crosswalk. If you cross the street without looking, an accident may occur, causing injury to you. If the driver swerves to avoid you, other people may also be injured. Many other behaviors, such as drinking habits, can put you and others at risk. It is important always to consider the injuries you might cause to other people as well as yourself. Being responsible to others includes such things such as staying away from people when you have an illness that can spread to others. This can be as simple as not going to school when you are ill. In choosing your health behavior, you will also be taking both physical and emotional risks. It is important to remember that not all of these risks are life-threatening. Some health risks will not kill you, but they may prevent you from living to your full potential. Just as there are degrees of good health, so too there are degrees of risk. This figure shows some of the degrees of health and risk on a wellness of continuum. you progress towards the right end of the continuum, you move in the direction of a higher level of physical, mental, social, and emotional health. At the same time, your health risk decreases. At the left side of the scale are illnesses and early death. The health risk increases towards the left end of the continuum. Now notice the middle area. This area is called the neutral zone. People at this point are not ill, but they are not specially well either. You probably know people at this stage. They may appear to be healthy, at least they do not appear ill, attend their classes and get along well with their family. They never seem to have any energy. They may eat too much, they are not very active in school or in sports. People in the neutral zone may not have a good self-concept. They seem to be just getting by. Even though the health risks at the middle of the wellness continuum are not fatal, they are chronic or long-lasting. The effect of such health behaviors over a long time can just be as negative in the later life as a disability or serious disease. People who live in the neutral zone of continuum suffer daily by not living up to their potential. Let's talk about how to make decisions. Evaluating the degree of risk may sometimes be comforting. It often helps to have a system for weighting things carefully. As this figure shows, a model for decision making that can help you make wise health choices. An example will show you how the model works. State the problem. Imagine that your friends, many of whom smoke cigarettes, are encouraging you to start smoking. Your best friend smokes, and so do your parents. Parents who visit often do not smoke and always ask your parents to quit. Every time you are with your friends, they want you to smoke a cigarette. You feel a great deal of pressure to start smoking. The problem or decision you must make is whether or not to smoke a cigarette. Now, identify your options. You have many options. You can go along with your friends and begin to smoke on a regular basis. You can choose not to smoke, and you could smoke only in the presence of your friends or not to smoke at other times. Choose one option. Now think about your options. Select the one that you think you would like the best. You may not have a clear favorite. In the example, imagine that you do not want to smoke. Evaluate the outcomes. What would be the positive outcome of that decision? You could feel the approval of your grandparents. You also might win approval from your parents, even though they smoke themselves. You could be free from the health risks that come from smoking. You would have saved money by not buying cigarettes. You would avoid the problem of stained fingers and teeth. You would have a greater endurance for the sports and other activities. Now consider the possible negative outcomes of your decision. Your friends may tease you. You might feel less grown up than your friends. Your friends may continue to pressure you to change your mind. How might you reduce these possible negative outcomes? You could ignore your friends' comments. You could develop other talents to make you feel grown up. You could simply tell your friends that you are responsible for making your own decisions. You might even consider making new friends who do not pressure you to smoke. You may decide that you need more information before you can make a firm decision. You can go to library to read books and articles about the effects of smoking on health. You can also ask people you respect, such as family doctors. Once you have more information, you have to evaluate the positive against the negative outcomes. It's time to decide and act. If you feel the negative effects of smoking are stronger than the benefits, you will make the decision not to smoke. Your action will be to refuse cigarettes. Review the results. Once you have acted, it is important to think that the results of your decision. Taking this last step in the model may either confirm your original decision or cause you to revive your thinking and make a new decision. You may even find that your friends respect your decision. You can use this model to look closely at any health decision. Evaluating all of these possible outcomes will help you to see all sides of even very difficult problems. By evaluating the outcomes before you act, you can change your mind and consider new options. You can avoid living through the outcomes of a poor choice. How to identify personal health risk? You have seen how you fit generally on the continuum of wellness and risk. Now is a good time to look at some specific personal health risk. It will help you to identify more specifically what health behaviors you may need to change. The inventory may call to your attention that you need to improve your diet. You may need to eat a wider variety of foods and avoid those that are high in salt, sugar, and fat. You may see that you need to exercise more often to maintain a normal weight and reduce stress. You may need to get more rest or try to express your emotion in a positive way. The inventory will also encourage you to think about how you care for yourself and use health services. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon button for more videos. Finally, the inventory may make you think about some things related to health that might never have occurred to you. For example, you may never before have connected safety and the environment with health. Let's review this lesson. You are responsible for your own health. To act responsibly for your own health and that of others, you should understand the risk involved in your decisions. Statistics can help inform you of risk. Using a model for decision making can also help make sure that you may consider options. Making good health decisions and forming lifelong health habits now will help you maintain a high level of wellness throughout life. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked today's topic, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell icon button for more videos. Thank you.